All right. How you doing? I'm Jeffrey Keith, and this is the Aimless News Report for Aloha Friday, March 3rd, 2023. And this is pretty much our system in a nutshell. We're paying taxes to pedophiles to stay out of a cage while they bomb children, destroy your savings, collapse the economy, and blame it all on you. Pretty much wraps that up. That's why this is important. Remember, the reason your family has never had to endure ground warfare in the United States is because every country knows that America is full of guns. Protect the Second Amendment like your life depends on it, because it does. All right, I'd like to start my news day off at What Finger News, the best news aggregate site on the interwebs. What Finger News at whatfinger.com. All right, we're going to get in something a little crazy here to start the day. The Gatekeepers Club. This guy, DPI, I don't know who this is. DPL, DPL's newsletter. He says, let's expose some gatekeepers. Well, we'll see. He says RFK is a gatekeeper, RFK Jr. Controlled opposition. The Gatekeepers Club. Now, there's some names on here that are going to piss people off. I don't know if it's true or not. But at this point, I don't rule out anything. He's got Judy Mikovits. I don't know. He's got a bunch of posts in here. And once again, I encourage you to do your own research and decide for yourself on this stuff. I don't know why anyone would listen to me. I'm just a fucking idiot. Carpenter with an attitude. David Martin. I've done a lot about him. He's on the gatekeeper list. We'll see. Mickey Willis. I never heard of that dude. Dolores Cahill. Yeah. Roger Hodgkinson. Stanislaw Brzezinski. Dr. Brian Artis. Dr. Perry Corey. Dr. Sherry Tenpenny. Uh-oh. This is going to piss off my buddy. Yeah, he's going to be a little irritated over there. Yeah, freedom.social. My buddy Kent, he's not going to like saying this name, but he's got no information on there, so who knows. Dr. Christine Northrup, Dr. Jane Ruby, Dr. Lee Merritt, Purnima Wag, never heard of him. Dr. Rashid Buttar, Stephanie Seneff, Jason Shirka, Steve Kirsch. Wow, this guy's naming names everywhere. Kevin McKernan, Jordan Peterson, Reiner Fulmick. Wow, this is the guy who's supposedly bringing all these people to court. Project Veritas. Well, my buddy Kent says that's a psyop. Peter McCullough, RFK Jr. And this includes the Children's Health Defense. A lot of big accusations here that I'm not agreeing with or disagreeing with. You do your own research. Look at this page. Click these links. Watch these videos. Find out for yourself. Robert Malone. I don't know this person. Stu Peters. Vladimir Zelenko. Nut Witkowski. Mike Adams, the Health Ranger. Del Bigtree. Sasha Stone. Alex Jones. David Icke. Oh, boy, he's got them all. And finally, Donald Trump, the vaccine pusher. Trump approved a $1.3 trillion spending bill for 5G. In March, even though some of his own citizens are asking for help against it. Yeah, you know my stance on 5G. Anyway, interesting, huh? This guy says every one of these people is controlled opposition. I don't know, but nothing would surprise me at this point. All right, the Murdaugh trial ended yesterday. The guy was found guilty. And this is the stupidest fucking thing ever. O.J. Simpson felt he needed to weigh in on this. Because people keep asking me my opinion of the Alex Murdaugh trial. Now, this was before the guilty verdict came out. So listen to this dumb motherfucker, what he's got to say.
Hey, Twitter world, it's me, yours truly. Well, a whole lot of people are asking me what I think about this Alex Murdaugh trial. I don't know why they think I'm an expert.
Oh, that's funny. I don't know why they think he's an expert. Maybe because you got away with murder? I don't know.
On it, but I got to admit, when he took the stand, a guy who's an habitual liar, I did.
Okay, he's talking about somebody else being a habitual liar. This is just classic.
Did watch when the trial first started. I watched him take the stand, and I thought it was probably a mistake because the guy is an admitted liar, and it's hard for me to think he could be on the stand 5, 6, 7, 8 days without lying. Question is, what did he lie about? But lying and stealing money is a little different than murder.
You would know, OJ, you motherfucker. Okay.
I realized in watching them testify what he was doing. He was just...
Because this is what you did.
Just trying to relate to one or two of those jurors that he was a good old boy. He was one of them.
Sort of like you did, huh, OJ? That was the game plan all along. Just get a couple of them jurors to be on your side.
And I'm not sure he didn't succeed in doing that. I am not qualified to really say if the guy did it or he didn't do it. You know, if a juror missed an hour of testimony, they no longer qualified.
All right, that was about as far as I could take that. Can you believe the balls on this guy? Just unbelievable. Anyway, Murdaugh was convicted. He was found guilty. Moving on, did an employee take a fall for Bill Gates? Over 6,000 child porno images discovered at his house. Now, this is a story that just came and went, got buried immediately, and we all know why. What was it? Gates gave the media about $300 million, you know, last year. So, you know, he can have a story buried anytime he wants. But this is very strange. Some dude, an engineer, employed it at the home, was busted for this. You can read through this, but, you know, so a Gates staff member took the fall? That's what it sounds like. Otherwise, you mean to tell me some guy was working at Gates compound and just decided to bring along with him 6,000 child porno images? Does that make sense to anyone? Or did he take the fall? This guy says he's not making accusations, just asking questions. Same as me. I don't tell you what to think. I just present the information, and you come to your own conclusions. So, what do you think? Does that make any sense to anyone? This guy was working there, and he brought 6,000 child porno images with him to work and got busted at Gates' house? Interesting how this story just got buried. I'll bet this gentleman, who is it? I bet he's very rich right now. Rick Allen Jones of Seattle. I bet he's living a real good life right now for taking that fall. I don't know if he's in jail or what. Oh, yeah, here it is. He was sentenced to 90 days in jail, so he's out. He's got a freaking great package of a payoff, I would imagine, to bury the story for Bill Gates. All right, another one. College Park mayor arrested on child pornography charges. The LGBTQ community is stunned as Wojan is taken into custody. Yes, sir. The gay mayor of this town in Maryland, College Park, is arrested. And the community, you know the community is stunned. This Dardano guy, a DC gay activist, has been friends with Wojan for many years. And he says, I am totally stunned and am literally shaking. This news seems too unbelievable. It has come as a thunderclap. I have known Patrick for decades. He has not only been such a wonderful and dedicated public servant, but had always been a kid fucker, apparently. Oh, wait, that just came out. That's not in the article. They're stunned, I tell you. The LGBTQUEXGYWXYZ community is stunned. You know who's not stunned? Everybody else. They're all fucking pedophiles. Something seems to be missing from the media coverage of the College Park mayor arrested for child porn. In case you missed it, this dude was arrested. The Washington Post, Merrick Mayor, was arrested Thursday morning. Name that party, Washington Post. Every one of these stories, from Brad Bell to everyone, nobody mentions that he was a Democrat. Now, if that was a Republican, that would be at the top of the headline, Republican mayor arrested and charged. You know how it goes. It just shows how corrupt the fucking media is. Covering for Bill Gates, not even mentioning whenever it's a Democrat. It's just unbelievable. 72-year-old man arrested for having 2,600 pounds of child pornography. I have never heard of child porn by the pound. Wow. Never heard of porn by the pound. Congress gave EPA 27 years to study how pesticides disrupt human hormones. The agency is yet to comply. A lawsuit filed late last year by a coalition of nonprofit groups accuses the EPA of failing to abide by a congressional order from nearly three decades ago. 27 years ago. They were supposed to follow through on the quality of all these pesticides that are used in food production. 27 years ago, and they still haven't given a report. As of the time of this filing, more than 25 years after the passage, the EPA has yet to implement the endocrine disruptor screening program it created, and further, has failed to even initiate endocrine testing for approximately 96% of registered pesticides. They just tell you they're safe. They spray this shit on your food. 27 years ago, they were supposed to provide a report on the safety, and they have 96 of these registered pesticides that have never been tested to what it's doing to you. EPA director makes a stunning admission about East Palestine. So this guy, EPA director Michael Reagan, said, out of an abundance of caution, we are advising parents to keep their children and pets out of creeks and streams near the derailment site. What? This contradicts what the agency said earlier, claiming that the water was safe to drink and the air safe to breathe. As a father, I would not advise anybody, adult or child, play in the creeks or streams. What we said is the drinking water has been tested. What? This water from the creeks and streams doesn't get into the drinking water? What a bunch of incompetent psychopaths we have in charge of everything. By 2050, used wind turbine blades will exceed 43 million tons of waste every year. There they are, 100 foot long each. Can't recycle them. They got to make them strong enough so they don't fucking break off and tip over in the wind, so the shit doesn't recycle. Wind energy is a fucking joke, just like everything else. It's unsustainable. EV cars are a joke. Solar panels are a joke. And speaking of that, the UN discusses darkening the skies to combat climate change. Well, wait a minute now. You're going to block out the sun. How's that going to work with solar panels exactly? I don't know. You know, I'm not a veterinarian, but that don't make much sense to me. You're going to block out the sky and yet we're going to use solar panels and everything? And what they're going to do is inject sulfur dioxide into the sky. And it used to be bad for us. Sulfur dioxide was a free byproduct of coal and oil burning, emitted into the atmosphere until recent decades. Environmental activists and authorities concluded that sulfur dioxide was a pollutant gas, contributing to the phenomenon of acid rain. Remember that one? And causing significant health problems. However, having been assured that sulfur dioxide was bad for us, we spent billions of dollars eliminating it. Now it turns out the sulfur dioxide is good for us. And we need to spend even more untold billions to inject it into the atmosphere to block out the sun. But then their fucking solar panels won't work. I can hardly keep up. Can you? All right. This guy better keep his head on a fucking swivel, I'll tell you that much. A potential whistleblower emerges with shocking details to expose Biden's corrupt family dealings. Dr. Gail Luft better keep his head on a fucking swivel, because he's been arrested in Cyprus on politically motivated extradition requests by the U.S. The U.S. claiming I'm an arms dealer. It would be funny if it weren't tragic. I've never been an arms dealer. Department of Justice is trying to bury me to protect Joe, Jim, and Hunter Biden. Uh-oh. Shall I name names? Oh, please, Dr. Left. Name names before you don't have a fucking head to name them with. Wonder if he knows Hillary. U.S. beef cattle has lowest inventory since 1962. Yeah, they're going to starve us out. This stuff all takes time to get all these supply chains broken down, all these meat plants burnt up, chicken farms burnt down, turkey farms burnt down, poisonous gases in all of our air and across the whole United States, seeping into the fields everywhere. What consumers experience at the grocery store is a product of what cattle producers were going through a year or two ago. So, you know what that means. It's coming, folks. They can't wait to get rid of your ass. All right. Yeah, I'm going to skip this one. Everybody's in credit card debt. We know that. Anyway, you know what? Instead, let's talk about your money real quick. If you have an existing IRA or 401k, it might be worth your time to consider switching your IRA or 401k over to an IRA backed by gold. You worked hard for your money, but it's up to you to protect it. You really going to trust the stock market with all this shit that's going on? Go to protectyourhardearnedmoney.com or click the link below this video to get your free 2023 Wealth Protection Kit that will show you how you can easily transfer your existing IRA or 401k to an IRA backed by gold with no fees and no penalties. But you should do it now, before all this shit hits the fan. All right, let's move on. New Jersey woman fighting eviction blows herself up in a house full of cats. That's right. She said, if I can't live here, fuck ya. Nobody can fucking live here. Well, that's one way I'd do it, I guess. Her and her cats burned up when she did not want to move. I don't know. That's a bit extreme. I don't know. Maybe she'd just move. All right. This is one of those times you do not want to fall out of the boat. This is a shark. Human frenzy. You must have had some bait on the lines there. Thanks. That is a lot of sharks. You do not. All right, let's take a look at this guy. I don't know what kind of training you have to have for this. How you would do this, I have no idea. But watch what this dude does. He sat on the fire. He just sat on the fire. Unbelievable. How do you train for something like this? Oh, wait a minute. He's going to lay down in there. He says, fuck it, I don't care. All right. We're back. I couldn't get out of that full screen. Anyway, I don't know what kind of training you need for that. Well, that's going to do it for this edition of Aimless News. Sign up to my email list if you'd like to be notified when I make new content. Comment, like, and share this video because you know why. The Aimless News must be heard. And let's listen to a little Vanilla Fudge, shall we? You guys have a great weekend. Aloha. Thank you.
Yeah.